I won't deny it, I'm a straight rider. You don't wanna fuck with me. Got the police barking at me, but they can't do nothing to me. Think I'm a smut, right? But so I go to this school dance and
I go to school there, I didn't know, I was like 11 years old, I didn't know that you had to take a shower and put on your good duds and sneakers. So I went there with still some of the pissy shit on me, and I was just a mess. And as soon as I came in, all the, everybody started laughing at me, and the people that was, that made me go on clean their coop and everything were laughing at me. Said, this dirty mother, he did this. And I mean, one guy was in the group, he was smoking weed, he was their brother, he was the older guy, he was the guy that bullied me, he was their older brother's friend. And he had watched these guys humiliate me, and I was just so humiliated, I started laughing with them. I laughed, but he said, meet me at the pigeon coop tomorrow, the same time, early in the morning, and I met him there. Same clothes on, horrible. I didn't have good hygiene and stuff like that. And this guy, he took me to his neighborhood, and a very high-end neighborhood, like Park Lane, something like that. And we started robbing the houses. We had started robbing all these elite people houses, and I didn't realize the adrenaline that I had to be in somebody's house where everything was open game and they weren't there and you could just take their personal stuff. And I robbed, and that guy took me to a shopping center and bought me a lot of nice clothes and stuff. He didn't give me much of the money, but he bought me a lot of nice clothes, and he had told me that if you want to be somebody, like, you have to be dapper, you have to, you know, be this guy. And that I went on a life of crime. And I made sure my mother was an addict, she died. My sister was an addict, she died. Uncharacteristically, my brother's a brain surgeon. I have a brother's a brain surgeon, right? We're very cordial, we don't talk, we're different kind of people. You know, I used to make fun. I say I randomly fix them. You know what I mean? Brain surgeon. But he's very, very private. They're just two different people. You know, I love my brother, but you know, my brother never seen me fight before. He's just not into my world. You know, you would never say brain surgeon or fighter. You know, but it's just not in the world. But my mother died when I was 15. But I went and met this guy. I was at reform school. You know, I had brought this house and got caught. And after the guy beat the shit out of me, they called the cops on him. And I was so happy because last year they caught my friend in the house and they killed him. The man that they told me how to rob houses. Someone caught him in his house and they killed him. And they had to call the cops on me. And I met him. It was this guy, this Irish guy, Bobby Stewart, right? You know, typical Irish guy, you know, like to drink and tough, you know, quiet. And I heard he was a national champion. I knew to see all the kids that was in this reform school that was good. They were on better levels. They had trust and stuff. I didn't have a trust system yet. So they would go on the weekend. They would go on the other side with Bobby Stewart, but they would come back with broken nose and broken ribs, and they were happy. And so I said, what's happening over there? They said, Bobby Stewart over here is an ex-professional fighter. And everybody knows, if you behave well, you're going, your grades come up in school, you can go over there and box them. So I wanted to go over to box them. I'm going to beat this white motherfucker. Everybody's going to love him. That's what I said, you know.